Hey, Kaijudo fans, this is Carl Reddish, and I'm here with Team Cyberware Games. Joe Bass just won the finals of Bedford KMC with this amazing 40-card. What do you guys call this?
Water, Darkness, Light, Tempo.
Okay. And now this is, I've seen this build. This is what I lost to in Top 8 in Louisiana.
It's very similar.
Very similar. That deck was 45 cards, you
yes,
said?
45.
This one's 40.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. 12 Shield Blast, you said?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Let's go over each one. Keeper Loss draws you cards.
Yep.
Works well with
attacks.
Other
yeah.
stuff going on. Lyra for the tap down.
Mm-hmm.
Andromeda for the shield regeneration. You were getting a 9 all the time?
With Finbar and Logo Scan, you can get to 9. There's some versions you don't have to play the 9 drops.
Yeah. Okay. But, like, they slow things down so you get to 9.
Yeah.
Cyber Scamp seems to be a linchpin. Is that correct or no?
It's been boss.
Yeah. They're ramping or playing control deck in the early game. It's just insane. Yeah. They just can't beat it.
Okay.
It's a way to apply constant pressure whenever you have your Cyber Scamp and your Keeper Loss. And it's like whenever you started crashing in, and they do have the shield blast, they have to get the if they do get rid of the Cyber Scamp, not only are you getting Ditto's effect, but you're also getting to draw the card off yeah. Keeper Laws, and you're just continuing to
they're either not using the shield blast, casting their spells, trying to get to the big card,
yeah.
and they're losing because they're not doing it.
That exactly happened in the finals against Sconcey. He had a Piercing Judgment, and he chose not to use it because. The replacement effect on Ditto is just that good.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Absolutely. Logo Scan, not seeing a lot of play, but obviously you love it.
Personal preference, one of my favorite cards.
Okay.
Very good.
It's great when you kind of have a lot of mana and you really got nothing to do and you're trying to dig for an answer. It's a great top deck.
It has late game applications. Originally, Jerry Thompson, Chris Anderson, they had built a blueprint for the list. And originally the Logo Scans were actually Gloom Hollows.
Okay.
But we liked being able to constantly be able to keep our hand full if we didn't have Finbar to keep applying the pressure. It's all about applying the pressure, keeping pressure, and then you go, you just keep applying pressure and just keep attacking.
Got it. This guy has the can't be a target.
Yes.
I mean, obviously great with the Keeper of Laws.
Yes.
Great finisher, just a great bottle target if it happens to be, stuff like that. Speaking of bottle, 3 bottle wishes.
Yeah.
How do you feel about it in this deck? Necessary? Compliments?
It's a great shield blast, and sometimes you get into situations where you just have to bottle.
Yeah.
I mean, you have a lot of great.
Slows down rush.
Yeah.
I mean, sometimes you'll have the rush player, they'll hit the bottle, and you do wind up getting a creature, and then you can revenge kill. It happened on another thing that we were top 4.
Yeah.
Scott broke, got bottles, got the Lyra, tapped down another Mega Bug, and then killed both of his Mega Bugs, taking over board control.
I had the same thing happen earlier. They tacked in first shield, busted bottles, hit Lyra, tapped their guy down, was able to revenge kill.
Crazy. Just makes shield blast creatures essentially.
Yeah, makes shield blast creatures.
Stuff like that. Now, General Finbar obviously has really stepped it up in this meta as opposed to 7 Clash.
Uh-huh.
So the bounce.
Bounce is insane.
Tempo just keeps you applying pressure.
I don't know. What do you think?
You get to draw cards like while your opponent doesn't want to play shield blast.
Yeah.
So it's just insane card advantage. And it's just great tempo card.
Yeah.
I don't know, would you say it's the best friend in the deck?
No, maybe in this deck, Finbar is the best.
Yes.
I'd have to say Finbar is the best, but close second would definitely have to be the Lost Patrol.
I have these laid out for a reason. I will come back to them. Screechy Care Adorable knocks out other Cyber Scamps without triggering Ditto.
The main reason,
Okay.
Yeah, it's the main reason. But I mean, sometimes you get to be able to, the can't block effect, the secondary effect through Screeching, sometimes it becomes relevant, which is you just have to get through. And you get the extra lethal, the lethal shield black breaks in.
Knocks out blockers,
Striders,
like Aggro Striders.
Balls, full metal.
Really good against Mono Light.
Yeah.
A Mono Fire, stuff like that. Bone Blades went with 3 instead of 2. I've seen some people starting to cut to 2. Still like the 3.
Well, it's there for the
early removal.
It's there for the Civ count as well. Just to keep
You
got the three Bone Blades and the 3 Terror Pits, and it just helps smooth the civilization count out.
Yeah, because there's a lot of multi civ. So.
Yeah.
Obviously, Terror Pit gets rid of any creature, Shield Blast, good stuff. Aqua Strider. Oh my gosh, Aqua Strider, everybody's running it. It's just from Mega Bugs to it was even in Sconcey's Dragons. It's just that good. Unlocks Light and Water right off the bat. Probably the best blocker in the game.
Oh, easily.
It's an Enforcer. Not relevant in this deck, but just solid card. I completely see why it's in there. Piercing Judgment. great removal, shield blast.
Keeps your tempo going.
Yeah.
Most important thing.
Personally, it's better than Storm Spark. So why that's in here.
Yeah. I was actually going to circle back to that. There is no Storm Spark in this. Just a little too slow?
In testing, we just found that Storm Spark was always just okay. Whereas, Bottle or Piercing Judge, the other Shield Blasts were always just better.
Yeah. They were strictly, they were pretty much just always better, but when it comes down to it, like when you get to the late game applications, when you get to the control did get to late game. We have basically what the next card was, is just Squillus. We just drop a Squillus and then just keep pushing through.
I guess. Absolutely. Now, Squillus is obviously becoming an all-star in so many decks right now. Control, tempo, everything like that. I clearly see why it's in here. Did you ever run into the bad situation of like turn 4 or 5 you're just getting hammered and then you hammer into Squillus and never it was bad for you? Or
that happened to me one time.
Yeah.
I mean, it didn't happen to me today.
It happened in testing. Yeah. But more often than not, you're usually hitting some form of removal. Mm-hmm. Or you're hitting a creature more often than not.
Yeah.
The Squillus is needed so much for if you get to the late game for against control in the other decks that it, the
Haven matchup.
Once in a while, you bottles into it. Very rarely, it's definitely worth it.
Now, just from walking around today and other tournaments and stuff, this guy, this the vanilla light darkness creature, Storm Patrol, is just Lost Patrol. Sorry, yeah. Lost Patrol. Just
it's insane.
Explain.
Bonkers.
It's insane. You drop it on turn 3 for 5k after you drop the scap. Your tempo game's insane. There's almost nothing that can deal with it. You just keep coming in. It just creates so much tempo where you didn't have it before. I mean,
not much deals with it before
Strider.
Turn 6.
It goes over Strider.
Swings past Herald, Strider, Lemon, every blocker.
You have the progression basically if you get it up turn 2 scamp, turn 3 Lost Patrol.
Turn
keeper, and you just keep
you're
going,
yeah.
And that's you just that it just progresses and tempos out, and then just,
yeah. And if you start stalling out, you can rely on your shield blasts, yeah. Yada yada yada.
And Lost Patrol, it's really hard to deal with for control list and the tempo decks. I played against two different style enforcer decks. I mean, they had great starts, but you drop down that Lost Patrol, and all of a sudden they're just not attacking anymore because anything they attack, you choose the best creature,
just slaughter them.
Yeah, I mean,
so the revenge kill on it's insane.
I mean, even like in the dragon matchup, I mean, you drop a turn 3 before they can drop their herald. You have Piercing Judgment to just sit there and bounce their bird, kill the herald. And it's just, they've lost pretty much at that point. They've lost so much tempo.
Yeah. So. Simple question, I'm going to ask it. If it was at 4 cost, would you run it?
No, because no, I mean, you have
it's just
you
not right in the curve.
There's no other 3 drop creatures, and you want a good curve.
Yeah.
So probably play Squeaky over it if that wasn't an actual card.
So I mean, at 4 we have Piercing Judgment, Keeper of Laws, Screeching, and Bone Blades. So we have the four slot is already pretty clogged. And I mean, it does everything you want it to want a 3 drop to
maybe
do.
Maybe 4 for 6k.
Yeah.
4 for 6k.
4 for 6k, my team.
Well, guys, this is a very great deck. You guys did very, very well with it today. Congratulations to you guys both. You will be, obviously, your first place, so
yes.
you'll be in Irving. Same with you, Jack.
Not qualified yet, so we'll see what happens.
All right. Well, guys, if you like this deck, leave a like, leave a comment, leave a subscribe. Congratulations again, guys, and I'll see you guys in Irving.
See you later.
Peace. Bye-bye.